Hello, and welcome back to the Knives Save Lives channel for yet another sharpening stone video review. This, you might not like this one as much because it's kind of a mystery stone. I know that it's a Norton stone. I'm pretty sure that the grit is probably like 220 and 600, something like that. It is a high wear stone. It wears down really fast. It works unbelievably good. This is a cheap stone. A friend of mine said he bought this at a hardware store for $10, brand new. And this was 2 or 3 years ago. And he had it brand new. He had it in an emergency pack that he had, or like a bug out bag type thing. And he just let me have it. I was like, wow, that's a pretty nice stone. Norton makes good stones. He's like, would you like to have it? I was like, well, you know, I don't want to put you out. But anyway, he sent me along the way with this. And I always have liked Norton stones. I used to work in a slaughterhouse for a time. And that is the brand of stones we used. We used a type of combination stone. It had a blue surface for the fine grit. And then it had a brown for the bottom. And it was an 8x2 stone. Something like that. It was a really large stone. And that thing worked phenomenally. Just used it with water, and it was a water stone. I'm not conflicting about the wet stone and wet stone and stuff. It literally was a water stone. And I used to use soap to sharpen with it. Liquid soap when I worked there, because that's the only thing I really had to lubricate the stone with besides water. And at the time, I generally always used oil, except for on that stone, because you can't use it because of contamination with the knives and whatnot. So I would just soak it in a equipment sanitizing sink, and that would clean out the soap really well. It was like 212 degrees, so it would cook that stuff right out of there. It was always boiling. And we used a combination India stone, oil stone, and that worked rather well, although I think it was a few steps down in function compared to the that water stone. I wish I knew the model number of it or the actual name for it, but that was like one of the absolute best stones I've ever used in my life. And I just can't get over how good their stones are. They might wear really quickly, but they cut steel so fast. It makes sharpening a quick breeze. This I did use for probably about 2 to 3 years, and you can see how badly it's warped or dished out. And that's just from a lot of use. And most of the dishing on this side that you see is because I was using that to reprofile knives, primary grinds. But this side, it may look fairly flat, but I've actually tried to resurface this stone on a sidewalk because it's so coarse. I just don't have anything else that'll cut it down. And you can see, like down here, that's the thickness of that layer of that grit. And then down here, it's actually fatter. Because when I was lapping it on the sidewalk, when I was pressing it, I was apparently pressing harder on this end and lighter on this end. And didn't quite get it as even, like, level. But it was very flat, straight across, just at an angle. So, but I usually sharpen with the stone in my hand like this anyhow, so it didn't really make much difference in the results that I was getting. But yeah, he said he spent like $10 on this, and man, it's worth it. $10 for a stone like this. They have ones called quick cut stones that work really well. I'm thinking that might be the one that I actually used to use that I couldn't identify earlier. This one is also a quick cutting stone, just in its performance. I'm not sure if that's the actual name of it. This one's made in Brazil. But it's just been a really good stone, and I've kept it. Stones are always a good gift, I think. someone gives me a sharpening stone, I tend to hang on to them. There's always a use for it. If it gets so worn out that you can't use it, like this one's getting to be, you can use it for sharpening on your axe or something. You know, something that doesn't require, you know, a really fine, precise edge. So just something that you just don't want it to be completely blunt. But anyway, you know, for the price and for the function out of one of these, I can't see why you wouldn't try one of these. I mean, you got, that's $36. That's $74. This is like $75 or $76 for this one. You know, that's $50 right there. There's another $50. This is like $250 or almost $300 worth of stones here. You know, that's, you know, I mean, if you don't want to go spend all that money on stuff like this, you know, I mean, which doesn't necessarily work any better, then stick with something like this. It costs $10. You know, it's a good choice. And, you know, for the money you'd save buying these, you could buy like a lapping stone even or whatever to keep this thing even for a long time, you know, instead of wasting all your money on these expensive stones. But it just depends on your personal preference, you know. The expensive ones do work well. You know, they're thicker and they're larger. Some of them are thicker. This is the Norton Combination 1000-8000 Pike Stone. This thing is a brick. I mean, it is a monstrous stone. I mean, this is a large stone. This is like 6x2. And that's a good sized stone. Honestly, though, this is enough. As I stated in one of my previous videos on the Shapton knives, this stone, I can't even hit this portion of it with my large knives. You know, this is a large knife. I mean, in my opinion, it's kind of just a medium knife, but, you know, in comparison to most average pocket knives, like a little old-timer 34OT, this is a freaking whale, you know. And actually, I do kind of think the Enduras are a large knife anyway, but I can't even hit the middle of the stone with this. You know, when you come down like this, you're not really even touching it. And sometimes I will take the tip and try to work it across that to try to get a little bit more wear done on there so that the wear is more even on the stone. But I do generally lap this about every time that I sharpen on it or every few times or so. That way I don't have a bunch of grit stuck in the stone, and hopefully it's, you know, releasing fresh abrasives each time I go to sharpen again. So that does provide more function. But anyway. But yeah, this stone is narrow, and you can see that even this stone, you're not going to hit the entire stone with this knife. So even that might just be a little bit much. Might be something, a size that might be better for like kitchen knives or something along that line. But there you have that. The Norton Mystery Combination Stone. If you can identify the stone, then feel free to leave it in the comments. Let me know. And thanks for watching.